Hi there, thanks for joining. Today we are going to look at the implementation of elk-stack with SSL certs implemented to it. We'll use Docker platform to spin elk containers, one container for Kibana and three containers for ElasticSearch nodes, and openssl to generate the root certificate and certificates for Kibana as well as for ElasticSearch nodes. All right, so the goal is to run elk-stack cluster with Kibana and ElasticSearch nodes into Docker containers and implement self-signed SSL certificates with each Docker container for secure data transit between the ElasticSearch nodes, the three nodes that we are going to spin, and between the ElasticSearch and Kibana, and between the browsers such as Chrome, Safari, and Kibana, and any data push into the ElasticSearch. At the end of the session, you will be able to generate the OpenSSL root and sign certs for the local host or your own domains. We will also learn to run elk-stack with Docker containers and also securing your elk cluster with SSL certs. All right, so our game plan is that we'll take a look at the Docker Compose YAML file and the certgen shell script. The Docker Compose YAML is a little bit customized. Basically, I took the template from ElasticSearch website and have customized it a bit so we can use the same YAML file for Mac as well as for Linux environment. And then the certgen.shell script is basically going to facilitate the generation of root cert and in fact the certs for Kibana and ElasticSearch. And it will also automatically add the root cert into a trusted list onto either Mac or Linux environment because there are many commands that has to be executed. So to keep the demonstration simple and also to facilitate you, I have created that script. I hope that will help. Then the next step is going to be cloning the Git repository, which basically contains the Docker Compose and certgen shell script. Then we are going to execute the shell script available into that. And as a last step, we are going to verify the implementation. The prerequisites for this implementation is that OpenSSL need to be installed into the machine, which is most likely that you already have into your machine, and then Docker and Docker Compose need to be available. The download resource URL, which is pointing out to the Git location, I'll also provide this location into the description of this video. All right, so we are looking at Automation's Git repository, and the URL for this is also available into the description of this video. So inside this, we have elk-stack directory, and then we have got two subdirectories, elk and elk-certs. Elk has the Docker Compose YAML file, whereas elk-cert has the certgen.shell script. So first of all, we can take a look at the Docker Compose YAML file. So this Docker Compose YAML file is made to spin three containers for ElasticSearch and one container for Kibana, all on one single network with SSL enabled. The little customization that we were talking about is addition of ulimits no file option into it. These are the two options. Those are required to spin a container onto the Linux machine. No file is basically an option for the maximum number of files that a process can run concurrently. The minimum number required for that is 65535. So in this, I have provided it a number 65536. And then memory lock, as in any process can lock the memory, what amount of memory any process can lock. So basically by providing -1, we have provided the maximum amount that is available. Okay, so into this Docker Compose file, you can see two certs, HTTP as well as transport for Elasticsearch nodes. Transport SSL will be used when Elasticsearch nodes will communicate within each other, whereas HTTP is being used when you literally go into the browser and hit HTTPS localhost with port number 9200, or maybe when you hit or push the data into Elasticsearch using any one of the beat or maybe logstash or any other third party tool. In total, we are going to use four environment variables when we invoke this Docker Compose YAML file: version, ES-certs directory, similarly Kibana certs directory, and host certs directory. Version is the version of Elasticsearch and Kibana that we would like to run inside our containers, and then the ES-certs and Kibana certs directory, that is for the internal location into the container where Kibana and the Elasticsearch containers will be able to look for those certs to get it implemented. And host certs directory is going to be a directory location inside the local host, the host machine of the Docker engine, where we are going to keep all our certificates, root as well as other certificates such as one for Kibana and for each Elasticsearch node. All right, now switching over to our cert gen file. Okay, so inside elk-stack and elk-certs, we have a shell script based certgen.sh. Okay, so this is a shell script, which basically the first command, executable command, says that we are going to generate the root ca.key with 2048 bit into it. Then we are executing a command to generate the root ca.pam file over here. Then there is a bit of logic to identify the operating system type. If it is Linux, then execute these commands such as install the CA certificates, update CA trust for to force enable it the CA trust, and then the copy the root ca.pam file, which is generated at row number 7, copy it into the location into the Linux machine, and then ultimately update the CA trust to trust the root cert that we have copied into this location. And then sysctl, this is basically setting up the variable vm max map count to 262144, because this is required to run Elasticsearch and Kibana containers onto, basically Elasticsearch container onto Linux machine. Then if operating system type is not Linux, then Darwin is the one for Mac operating system. So if we are running this script onto Mac operating system, then it is basically going to add the root ca.pam file, which is again generated at row number 7, and it is just going to add it into trusted roots. Otherwise, this script is basically limited as of now. I have tested this script onto Mac as well as on Amazon Linux flavor, and it is working fine over there, but please feel free to contribute with this script and add other platforms also, like Windows and maybe from Ubuntu family and other flavors of Linux. Then starting from row number 29, it is going to generate the certs for ES01, which is Elasticsearch node 1, 2, and 3, and then also it will generate the certs for Kibana. After all of that, we are actually calling the Docker Compose up as a daemon process, And then these are the four variables that we were talking about while looking at Docker Compose: version, host certs, dir, es certs, dir, and kip certs, dir. So es certs and kip certs, dir, they are expected to remain inside the container, whereas the version is that we are passing, like 7.8.0 version is what we are looking for Elasticsearch in Kibana. And then the host certs dir, basically where we have exactly kept all our certificates that we have generated using this script. All right, so enough of theory, let's get on to the actual implementation. So here I have opened the terminal into my laptop, and then we are going to clone the repository, the Git repository, and again URL for this is available into the description, so please pick it from there. We are executing git clone command. All right, so it has cloned the repository into automation folder, so I'll quickly change my directory to automations. See elk-stack, we'll get into elk-stack, and in fact directly into elk-certs directory. Here we see the certgen.shell script. So we will quickly change the permission to execute the script. All right, just to verify. All right, everything looks fine. Exit. So now we are going to execute this shell script. Prior to this, let's quickly check if by any chance I have a localhost certificate added. All right, so I don't have any localhost cert added into my machine right now. We can execute this certgen shell script with starting with command sudo, then it is a bash script, so we'll call bash and then certgen.sh, and we will pass the parameter which is going to be a password or passphrase for our root cert. So I will simply provide my password over here and hit enter. So the password right now that it is asking for is sudo, so basically you have to put in your sudo credentials in here. I've entered mine and it has started all the execution and also creating network elk-stack and creating the container Elasticsearch 1, 2, and 3. Kibana container is dependent on the health of ES01. So as soon as Elasticsearch 01 container is declared healthy, that is when the Kibana container spin up will kick in. All right, so we see that the Elasticsearch 1, 2, and 3, and even kip01 is now created. Just to verify, we say docker ps. All right, so I see the Kibana Elasticsearch 1, 2, and 3, all these containers are running. So we can now meanwhile quickly take a look at the trusted cert. Now if you see a local certificate is added, Basically, it is a local host certificate. If you want, into your certificates, you can add subject alt name. You have to modify the certgen.shell script. Now, one catch with this is the implementation of it, the first time spin of these Docker containers is going to take a bit of time. As of now, let's try curl minus l and try to hit HTTPS localhost 9200, which is a URL for Elasticsearch. All right, so this is responding. So Elasticsearch at least is up. But if I, as of now, hit for Kibana, most likely it is not going to work. At my machine, with the configuration of around 6 core and 16 GB RAM, it takes up to 12 minutes for Kibana to respond. So we have to be really patient with it. You see, SSL error syscall. This is expected. Please give it some time. So for next few minutes, I'm going to pause this video. All right, so here I am. After around 8 minutes, I have logged in again. So I see now the Kibana localhost 5601 should be responding. Taking a bit of time. Alright, so it seems the HTTPS URL here is working with Kibana, and quickly we'll check once for Elasticsearch also at port number 9200. Alright, so this is also responding. Let's do one quick search. Let's do one quick test with the Google Chrome. So localhost 9200, all right. The little lock sign over here, this shows that this site is secure with a certificate. And if you click on this lock sign here, we can take a look at the certificate also. Details. So basically it expires on December 29, 2021. And all the send names and everything, the subject alternative name, ES01, DNS name is localhost. And similarly, if I go to Kibana, the localhost 5601, this is also secured now. So we see a little lock sign over here also. We can click on this, connection is secure. Click on certificate and can look at all the details. The certificate is valid, expires on December 29, 2021, with all other details such as SAN and how many bits has been used. So subject alternative name. So this is how easy it is to implement SSL certs with the elk-stack and in fact the elk cluster. And I hope the shell script and the a little customized Docker Compose YAML file is going to help you a lot. All right, I hope this content has helped you today. If you like the content, then hit like button and subscribe the channel. Feel free to leave feedback in the comment section. Goodbye and take care until I see you next.